If you've ever purchased a water hose from a department store, you know that the bigger the hose, the more flow you get, the better water pressure you have, and the faster you can actually fill up your bucket. Electricity flows through wires in the same way. The pressure is called the voltage. The flow of water through the hose is going to be the current. And the size of that water hose, that's the resistance. The relationship between voltage, current, and resistance is called Ohm's law, and it's one of the most fundamental things that we can learn as people who want to do off-grid solar or just a little bit of electrical work around your home or property. And once you figure this formula and this theory out, which seems kind of out there at first, but once it clicks, everything else from wiring solar panels to building systems like the ones behind me make an awful lot more sense. Ohm's law is actually pretty simple. It tells us how voltage, current, and resistance work together in any electrical circuit. And the math for that, or the calculation, is V equals I times R. V, that's pretty simple. It's going to be the voltage. It's the electrical pressure measured in volts. I, this is current, and current is the flow of electricity measured in amperes, or amps for short. And oftentimes you'll see that as an A. Then R is for resistance, and this is how much something resists that flow measured in ohms. And if you know any two of these, you can always calculate the third, and that's what makes Ohm's law so useful. The best way for me to think about Ohm's law is to think about water flowing through a pipe. So you have the voltage, which is the water pressure, and that's just how much or how hard the water is pushing. If you've got a really high water tower, you're going to have a lot of pressure. You've got a really powerful pump, you're going to have a lot of pressure. So that is V, the pressure. Then we have the I, or the current, and that is how much water is actually moving through that pipe. And then finally, we're going to have the resistance, and resistance is going to be based on how big that pipe actually is. Do we have a, you know, good, what is this, a 3-inch pipe, or do we have a, what is this, 1.25 inches, I think? Or do we have a little water hose like this, a spigot, and the resistance is that choking off right there, okay? So it can be that. It can also just be simply going from a larger hose down to a smaller hose, or it can actually be that choking off. But that's what we want to think about as the resistance. So if we have this guy right here on the end of a water hose and we increase the water pressure, say my well pump, it kicks back on after the pressure is lowered down and the pressure starts to go up, I'm going to get more flow through here. I'm going to get more of the current or amps, and we can discuss it that way. But if I start to add resistance, even though I'm adding pressure, the resistance can actually slow down the amount of flow or current that's coming out of the water hose. And that's how all of these different items, or these three, you've got the voltage or the water pressure, the current or the amount that's flowing through, or the choking off, the resistance. They all three work together. If you adjust two of them, the third automatically adjusts also. Now, before we go any further, I want to go ahead and make sure that I state that I am not an electrician, but that's exactly why I wanted to make this series, because I know what it's like to be on the other end of it, wanting to build something like this, but not understanding all the bits and pieces and how this works together and being overly intimidated by electrical theory. And so I wanted to just break it down and make it as simple as possible for anyone else who's wanting to do something like this. So that's a disclaimer. However, I am utilizing some of the best information that I can find. And one of the best things that helped me along the way was the document Wiring Unlimited, and it's put out by Victron Energy. I'm gonna link to it below, and I'll have it on my website where all of these videos are gonna reside. So that is a fantastic document. We're gonna go through most of that information here. If you're like me and you like the videos as opposed to just reading through documents, stay tuned, we're gonna work through it together. So that is Ohm's Law in a nutshell. It's a simple tool, and don't freak out if you still don't grasp it all right now. Over time, it'll sink in, but my goal here was basically just to give you an introductory, just an introduction to the concept. So what's gonna happen next? Next, we're gonna walk through how we use Ohm's Law to calculate power. And this is actually the formula that I utilize the most. I always want to know how much power my units are producing or consuming, and that is the most useful thing to me. We're going to get into it, and that's going to be in the next video, so stay tuned for that. And if you're just joining the series, go ahead and rewind this if you need to a couple of times. Check out some of my other videos if I don't have the power video out yet. They're gonna be over here. Check out those videos. This one right here, YouTube thinks is best for you. And this is gonna be where the power video is. I'm Eric, encouraging you to live faithfully and prepare thoroughly for good times or bad. See you in the next one.